I'm back with another super interesting piece of research that I wish everybody knew about. Today, we are talking about behavioral genetics. Of everything I've learned in my career, this piece of information is one that I think about at least once a week. For a little bit of context, psychologists have always been interested in how and why people behave in certain ways. And a long-standing debate used to be, is this more about genetics influencing people's behavior, or is it more about the environment that they live in influencing their behavior? And we have had a consensus for some time that it's both. But the question we're left with is, how much of each is contributing? Is it more about our genes for certain traits? Is it more about our environment for other traits? How about the way that they're interacting with each other in different conditions? We don't conduct these types of experiments in humans to tease apart the effects of our genes from our environment. However, that isn't to say that this world isn't full of, quote, natural experiments where we can glean information from things that are happening organically in society. One of those natural experiments includes identical twins who are separated at birth. So they have 100% exactly identical DNA, but their environments are completely different. And today I'm going to be talking to you about the Jim twins. There's a set of identical twin boys who were born in 1939 in Ohio and separated 3 weeks after birth when their parents got divorced. They were both raised by separate families in Minnesota, 40 miles apart from each other. Both boys were named James by their adoptive parents, but chose to go by the nickname Jim. Their names are Jim Lewis and Jim Springer. Jim Lewis knew that he'd been separated from a twin at birth. Jim Springer had been told that he had a twin, but they had died during childbirth. So at 40 years old, Jim Lewis recruited a researcher, Thomas Bouchard, to help reunite him with his identical twin. And of course, Thomas Bouchard was interested in understanding what similarities these two men might have because their DNA was completely identical, but the environments they grew up in were completely separate. So Jim Lewis and Jim Springer are reunited at the age of 39 years old, and they start comparing notes. First, both of them had a younger brother named Larry. Also, both loved the subjects of math and hated spelling. They both had hobbies in carpentry and woodworking. Both of them bit their fingernails and got migraine headaches. They were both chain smokers, the same brand, Salem, and they both preferred to drink Miller Lite. They both worked part-time in law enforcement. They both drove a light blue Chevrolet and would drive that Chevy to the exact same beach in Florida where they liked to vacation with their family. They both grew up in a house with a dog named Toy. They both had sons, and they both named their sons James Allen. They were both married twice. The first time, each of them married a woman named Linda. They both divorced Linda and married a woman named Betty. This is just observational research. It could all be chalked up to coincidence, but that just seems impossible. What this suggests is that there are genetic contributions over and above what's happening in our environment that are determining what we do and who we become. Like, where's the gene for growing up with a dog named Toy, or marrying a woman named Linda, and then a woman named Betty? I can't. And this isn't the only example of this. There's another set of twins, Jack and Oscar, who were separated shortly after birth. One was raised in Germany and became a Nazi. The other was raised a Jew. They were reunited at some point, and despite their widely disparate environments in life, both of them thought it was hilarious to sneak up behind somebody and sneeze really loud to scare them. What's the gene for that? If any of this sounds interesting to you, you have to watch the documentary Three Identical Strangers. It's about triplets who were separated at birth and intentionally, unethically, placed in a low SES, medium SES, high SES home and were studied through their childhood to see if they could identify the distinct genetic versus environmental factors that are influencing who they become. They all, by coincidence, found each other at the age of 19, and the story goes from there. Highly recommended. All of this just speaks to how little we understand about the human condition. There aren't any scientific articles written on the Jim twins, but if you want to know more, I recommend you Google the Minnesota Twin Study and the work of Dr. Nancy Siegel. She does all things twin related. It's fascinating, you guys. Check it out.